Hey, what's up guys, Phantoms Y here, back with some more G-Senjou no Maou. And last time we left off at the borderline of Tsubaki's route, for real this time, I double checked just to make sure I wasn't talking out of my ass again. But yeah, here we are on the cusp of it, and we are going to branch off into her route. We are going to choose to invest in Tsubaki, and that is going to take us directly onto her route. So, everything's been leading up to this, right? So let's see where it takes us. Is that okay? I ask myself this question once more. If I choose Tsubaki here, I feel there'll be no turning back. I have ambitions of my own. Not to mention, I'm also curious about Usami and her relation to the fierce criminal calling himself Maou. Even so, will I help Tsubaki? Devote myself to Tsubaki. Yeah. I shouldn't have any more hesitation. I don't know when it first began, but as I stand here, I find myself attracted to Tsubaki. Tsubaki. Her face, puffy from crying, slowly turned my way. I hailed out her diary and averted my eyes. You forgot this. Tsubaki sniffled, then smiled. It was a pure smile. Bye.
Asahi-kun, matte.
She stopped me. If I let her stop me here, I'll become irrevocably drawn to her.
Ouchi de gohan tabete kanai?
No thanks.
Nei-chan no kareshi oide yo!
Hiroaki's expression was exactly the same as his sister's. I'm a bit busy. Do you have time later tonight?
Yoru?
There are some things I want to talk to you about.
Hanashi?
It's about our relationship. It's decided then. I'll call you later. The moment I turned, I slipped fantastically onto the snow-slick ground. A bright, cheerful sound immediately filled the surrounding air. Tsubaki's eyes widened. What? Looks like I'm out of it tonight. Oh, sure. Next time. I only said that casually, but he took it for a promise.
Yokattane, Hiroki. Azai-kun ga kankeri suru tte sugoi koto da yo.
As did his sister, I guess. Don't tell me I really have to go through with this boring little game now.
それじゃ、わざわざありがとうね。
Yeah.
また夜にね。連絡待ってるね。
Yeah.
どうしたの?
No, it's nothing. I suddenly realized that I couldn't keep my eyes off her face. I'm heading home. I quietly bid her farewell, for real this time.
じゃあね!
That bright, clear voice still lingered in my ear. I find myself flustered. I want to just lie down and clutch my head. For crying out loud, the girl doesn't even have a penny to her name. I tried to work. My foggy mind could not escape its many torturous, invasive thoughts of Tsubaki. Tsubaki's chapter, Mirror. So here we go. Come in.
お邪魔します.
9 p.m. The swirling snow soon stopped. After a brief consultation session with a local firm, I went to Tsubaki's house and brought her over. Would you like some coffee?
いいよ.
Really? I looked away idly.
今日雪降ったね.
Yeah, the trains were canceled everywhere.
だよね.
Yep. The silence continued.
Asai-kun, あのね, ちょっと... お願いがあるんだ.
A request?
いきなりで本当に申し訳ないんだけれど...
Her eyes shifted to the paperwork she'd been going through earlier. I already understood. Don't worry about it.
え?
This is about the work I gave you, right? You don't need to help out if you don't want to. That kind of job doesn't really suit her anyway.
あ、いや、そうじゃなくて...
Tsubaki quickly shook her head.
これから家族とも過ごしたいから、ちょっと手伝えないこともあるかもっていうお願いだったの。
Don't push yourself. Your family's huge, after all. Between cooking, bathing, and playing, I'm honestly surprised you're even able to manage school up to now.
それは大げさだよ!
Really? Regardless, you should put your family first.
うん。でも、私にとっては、浅井君も家族と同じくらい大切だから。
She put it so simply. I distinctly felt my breath stop cold.
手伝うよ! いや、 手伝わせて。私、浅井君のこともっと知りたいの。こんなこと言ったら怒るかもしれないけれど、浅井君ってとってもその寂しい子供時代を過ごしたんでしょ?
Why would I mind you saying that? It's the truth. Still, I didn't feel like I was particularly lonely.
そういう浅井君が、なんだか、とても寂しそうなの。Tsubaki。私には、わからないような苦労してるって知って、力になりたいって思ったの。Tsubaki
seemed a little agitated.
何でも言って。私、浅井君の言うことなら、何でも聞くよ。Alright,
go hop in the shower.
Huh?
Wait, no, I'm kidding. It was a bad joke. Tsubaki's face was boiling red. Hey, calm down. I told you, it was just one of my usual crappy jokes. Seriously.
だよね。びっくりした。
Damn, I thought she'd find that funny. Anyway, I wanted to talk to you about something. Tsubaki nodded obediently. I may just be flattering myself here, but... You like me, right? Tsubaki suddenly stiffened up. She lowered her head and trembled uncontrollably. Then, with a red face, she nodded slightly.
その、ずっと前から、声かけたくて、一緒に学園終わって、一緒にCD変えて、嬉しくて、 最近は構ってもらえる時間増えて、いつ言おうかなって、言うっていうのは、告白のことで、だから、はい。Tsubaki
glanced up at me adorably.
浅井君が好きです。
The momentary silence befell us once again. I should be saying something right now. Let's go to school together tomorrow morning.
Eh?
That was kind of my way of saying, stay the night with me, Tsubaki.
それはどういう?
I embraced her tightly.
Eh?
Tsubaki, because of the surprising turn of events, is extremely confused. Means something like this. I reach out for Tsubaki's sweater. With my hand on her top, Tsubaki seems to finally understand what I'm trying to say. Yet she doesn't resist in the least. Tsubaki spoke softly. After hearing that, I started to take off Tsubaki's clothing, piece by piece, article by article. Tsubaki watched me take off her clothes from start to finish.
I did gagoogity that girl. I geschmoigity her geflavity with my googus.
So was it good for you guys too?
Ohayo.
Good morning. Tsubaki's smile was the first thing my hazy eyes saw today. And wouldn't her family be worried sick? Oh right, of course she didn't. Yeah. Oh, really? Actually, something smells pretty good. I guess it's wafting in from the kitchen. Sorry, I'll pay you for it. Naturally, I went looking for my wallet.
寝ぼけてるの? お金なんているわけないよ。
Well, I can't just eat for free. Wait, why can't I?
聞いてもいいかな? 私って... その...
After all, this girl's not just a classmate anymore. Yeah, you're my girlfriend. She's more like family.
よろしくね, Kyousuke-kun.
A refreshing new day began.
Kyousuke, 昨日はよくもバックレてくれたな。
What the hell, kid? I skip all the time, and you never get on my ass like that.
まあな。だがよ、 椿も無断で休んだんだぜ。
Jeez.
さすがのおれちゃんもよ、あの椿がバックレかますとさすがに心配ぶっこいちゃうわけだよ。というわけで、お前なんか知らね?
I wonder.
Huh?
Hey, face, too close. I can hear you from over there.
たくよ、パーティーも中止だし、なんか最近椿に振り回されるんだよな。
So, Tsubaki still isn't here?
なんか職員室に行ってたぜ。
Why?
俺が知るかよ!
He started cursing with a terrifying hilarious expression. This joker, he may be a dumbass, but his instincts are strangely accurate. I don't even want to think about what he's going to do after he finds out about my relationship with Tsubaki. Huh? Sure, why not? I answered without thinking. Tsubaki danced into the classroom, full of energy.
Yeah,Tsubaki-chan,心配したんだよ.
And thus, Aichi began his flattery.
ごめんね、昨日のことだよね.
うんうん、僕心配で心配で、ペットの餌を買いに行くの忘れちゃったよ. どうしてくれるの?
ごめんね、今先生にもお話ししてきたんだけどね.
うんうんうん、病気でもしてたの?
昨日… ずる休みしてたの。
え?リアル?
Tsubaki's single phrase had enough destructive power to knock Aichi back to his true self for an instant.
昨日だけじゃなくて、この前も午前中遅れてきたことがあったけど、 それも大した理由じゃなかったの。
そうなの? なんでまた?
遊びたかったの。
Tsubaki spoke without a shred of worry. Aichi must have found it a little overboard that she went all out of her way to do that. And I agree with him. She's back to her little Miss Perfect self. Tsubaki expressed a full-on smile. Happily went to her seat and started to mark the attendance. What the hell does even mean? Aren't you into older girls? I will say, I've ragged on the Little Miss Perfect type character before, particularly in Decapo 2. I really dislike Otome from that game. I feel like Tsubaki, because her character is given a lot more depth and such, I feel like I actually like Tsubaki. She doesn't irritate me, which is rare for that type of character. But anyway, just goes to show that this game does its characters that well.
朝起きたら何も言わずにトーストとスクランブルエッグが出てきそうじゃん。レタスを添えて。
I couldn't help but stay quiet.
どうした？
Because that's exactly what happened. Nothing. Damn it, kid. Will you get your face out of mine? Before long, we were eating lunch at the usual place. After arriving early at the rooftop, Usami called to me. What do you mean, thanks? If you were grateful, you wouldn't have accused me of being a criminal. You're stubborn, you know that? Do you have any proof at all?
Nice.
Usami was playing with her bangs, as always. What do I think? If you're not confident about it, then don't start spouting it. Look, I don't care. Just don't suspect me again, okay?
すいませんね。一応浅井さんが犯人でもそれなりに筋は通るんで、つい。
Usami's hair lowered and began to swing like willow branches.
はるちゃん、ちょっといいかな？
Tsubaki called to us from afar. What, Usami?
あ、いえ、椿の顔色が良くなったなと。
Tsubaki jogged over to Usami.
はるちゃん、ごめんね。
Tsubaki suddenly bowed a bit.
ん？最近、きつく当たってたでしょ？はるちゃんは精一杯やってくれたんだよね。廃墟の探索とかしたんでしょ？お父さんから聞いたんだけど、女の子が一人で行っていいようなもんじゃないって。
Usami was silent for a moment, then solemnly opened her mouth.
私ももう警察に連絡しろという気はない。え？本当？椿たちが犯人の報復を恐れたとしても、それは責められるようなことではないと反省した。悪かった。何も力になれなくて。
I alone tilted my head quizzically. Usami will pursue rationality, wherever it may lead her. She probably realizes that even if they become involved, the police would say it's much too late now that things have progressed this far. There's been a decent amount of time since the incident. As the victims, Tsubaki and her family probably don't remember it vividly enough for testimonies, and Maou might have destroyed all evidence already.
Haru-chan...ひどいこと言ったりして、本当ごめんね。これからは大丈夫だから、仲良くしてね。
It'd probably, probably be best for me to leave. There was nothing for me to do in the classroom either, so I thought of sending a text message to Tsubaki. No, knowing her, there was no chance she actually brought her phone to school. I'll just call Miki-chan.
Kyousuke-kun!
What?
何驚いてるの？電話？
Are you finished talking to Usami already?
うん、はるちゃんがもういいからって言ってくれたの。
That's great. Usami was being pretty annoying, but you were acting a bit strange yourself.
はるちゃんには本当に申し訳なく思ってるよ。
Her voice just got quieter and quieter.
あのね、私…嫉妬してたんだと思う。はるちゃんが京介くんのこと好きなんじゃないかって思うと、いても立ってもいられなくなってたの。
I even invited Usami to my room once. I thought you might have been worried about that.
最初はいけない気持ちだなって思ってたんだけど、途中から何がいけないんだろうって思い始めて、最後には。ハルちゃんなんて許せるわけないって、イライラしてたの。
Ah, well. It was a good experience at least, right?
うん。もう二度と味わいたくないけどね。
She cheerfully stuck out her tongue.
今日、会ってもらえる？
Yeah, sure. I hesitated, but there was no reason to refuse. Oh, but I won't be available until late tonight.There are some things I still need to take care of. Some insignificant things like club activities.
いいよいいよ。 私もいろいろ溜まってることあるから、ヒロアキとサエを迎えに行って、その後お母さんを病院送って。
Sounds exhausting.
あと、一番溜まってるのは日記かな。
She flipped it open and perused it for a moment.
そういえば、Kyousuke君ってお昼いつもパンだよね。
Yeah.
明日から私が作ってもいいかな。
Tsubaki asked my permission, embarrassed. I too was afraid that someone in class would hear. I don't usually like attention.
Dame.
Sorry about that. My knee hit the desk. Still, in the face of that fawning voice, I couldn't help but nod. No, it's a yes. That'd be great. I answered curtly.
Arigato. Daisuki.
My knees almost buckled. I was planning to remind her not to expose our relationship, but thanks to her declaration, I forgot. I didn't feel quite right for the rest of the day. And yet, I still ended up going to club. Usami? Usami's here? Hello, everyone. The role of God this week will again be played by me, as I, Kyousuke. Hey, what the hell is Usami doing here?
Huh?
Hey, Eiji. I thought this lab equipment storage room was our Jerusalem. What's with you two? Are you in this together?
Etekichi.
There are factions now? Whatever, what do you want today, human scum?
Huh?
How disgusting. Stop beating around the bush and repent.
Okay.
Wait, you intend to rebel against God?
Oh
no.
Wait.
What on earth are you talking about?
この語に及んで言い逃れとは見苦しい。やっておしまいな。
I said wait!
すでにネタは上がってんだよ。
Material?
証拠という意味です。
I know that, asshole. What kind of material is it? Talk.
簡単な推理だよ、ホームズ君。
Who are you? Who are you to present your opinions to Holmes?
いやいや、ついさっき、ツバキにね。ねえ。
Tsubaki just…
直で宣言されましてね。
Oh god.
Kyousuke君の彼女になりましたって。
いきなりそんなこと言われてもね。いやいや、ツバキはだから燃えるんだよ。
Why in front of everyone? Tsubaki… Damn, it's all over now. I should have told her.
言い訳はそれだけですか。んじゃ。とりあえずやっておしまいなさい、フリーザさん。
First you talk down to Holmes, now you command Frieza? Or Frieza?
じゃ。
He leaves me with a glare, as if looking at something dirty. Hey, wait.
凌介には失望したぜ。
With a sigh full of deep contempt, Eiji fled the storage room.
アザイさん。
What do you want, you bitch?Have you not done enough damage already?
いえ。それにしても椿ですか。
You got a problem with that?
自分の数少ない友人の一人ですし、ぜひぜひ幸せにしてください。
This whole thing is becoming quite the nightmare.
ま、後のことは私に任せてください。
Oh, excuse me. Go on.
What are you talking about? The rest of what?
例えば、魔王とかです。
I thought you were convinced I was Maou. Usami is always so aloof, so I have no idea what she's thinking about.
例えば、あの身代金ダッシュ、覚えてますよね。私はまんまと空のケースを運んでしまいましたが、後でよくよく考えたら、それなりに見えたものがあるんです。
I'm Maou, and I copied the coin locker key beforehand, right?
そういう可能性も完全に捨てきれるものではないなと思っていますね。
I can't deal with this chick anymore. Oh, I'm going out with Tsubaki. This shouldn't have anything to do with you. After pausing for a few seconds, Usami finally, softly nodded.
一つだけいいすか?
The atmosphere wouldn't permit of refusal. Just what is it with her?
幸せにね、Kyousuke君。
The girl before me said this with a slightly lonely expression. Usami turned around and left. She never turned back. A lonely feeling welled up within me, but it was only temporary. I'm very forgetful, after all. The feeling of nostalgia I experienced from Usami calling out my name would surely soon disappear into the furthest reaches of my memory. I left school and headed for Tsubaki's house.The moment I arrived, I was mobbed by her family. Wait a second, get off me.
Asai-kun, irasshai. Gohan, mata da yo ne?
Mochiron, tabete iku yo ne. Kimi mo, uchi no kazoku nan da kara ne.
Pardon? Please, God. Hey, Tsubaki, please don't tell me that even your dad... I asked her in almost a whisper. She answered with a smile. Fine, but why'd you tell Eiichi and Usami? I guess there's no reason you shouldn't. Oh well, it would have gotten out someday anyway. Might as well give up. Thanks for inviting me.
Yoshi, Asai-kun. Yeah, Kyousuke to 呼ばせてもらおうかな。
Kyousuke, お兄ちゃん! 姉ちゃんをよろしくね! よろしくね!
The house really has a lively atmosphere. The kids chimed in under father's leadership. The father's leadership.
はい、Kyousuke-kun! いっぱい食べてね!
A mountain of rice sat on the table.
お姉ちゃん、お嫁さんだ!
そう? 嬉しいな!
I ate without a sound.
Oishi?
Tsubaki just kept looking at me. Dinner was beef and potato stew. It's good.
Honto? Ureshii na.
The atmosphere is rapidly becoming awkward. I can't help but feeling out of place here.
Otou-san, watashi no nikujaga yappari oishii tte.
Honto kai, Kyousuke-kun? Oishii tte yuwasareteru n janai no kai?
Not sure how to respond to that one. In any case, eating with her parents on her first day as a couple is kinda... As these random thoughts filled my head, Tsubaki just kept on looking at me with a smile. What?
Kyousuke-kun って箸の持ち方変だよ。
あ、本当だ。
変だ。誰かだ。
Hey, it's not like I'm doing things the hard way or anything.
とかなんとか言ってこぼしてるよ。口で取ってあげるね。
What? In front of her parents? Tsubaki's father, along with Tsubaki herself, burst out laughing.
また Kyousuke君のお茶目なところが見れたのでした。
Don't write about this in your diary, you hear?
やだよ。Kyousuke君の書を作ってあるんだから。
Whoa, that's pretty scary. Damn, something must be wrong with me. I just can't function well in a warm environment like this one. Excuse me, sir. Are you still using the soy sauce?
Oi, oi! Otou-san de ii daro! Nani wo enryou shite iru nda? Kyousuke-kun wa shumi toka aru no kai?
Huh? Pardon?
Classic da yo, Otou-san!
Oh, Beethoven da!
Yeah, a couple others too.
Oh, 知ってるよ。Kitajima Saburo とかだろ?
How on earth am I supposed to answer that? Yeah, I'm also into computers and such. Tsubaki's father hit his palm with a fist.
あれだ! Mixi だ!
My Twitter. He looked so proud of himself that I couldn't bring myself to correct him. Something like that.
Hey, Oni-chan. Oni-chan no oniku moratteii?
Hora, Hiroaki. Oniku bakkari tabenai de, yasai mo tabenasai.
Niniyaka ne.
Oh, Okaazan. Okita no?
Tsubaki ni karesi ga dekita tte kiite, nete rarenaku natta no.
Hello, my name is Asai Kyousuke.
Shitteru wa yo. Tsubaki ga osewa ni natte masu. Watashi ga byouin ni itta toki wa, kuruma de tasukete kureta toka.
Please, I only called a taxi.
Ano toki, sukkoi tayori ni natta yo. Okaa-san, motto Kyousuke-kun ni kansha shite yo.
You're laying it on thick, Tsubaki.
Minotsu no honjin mitai na mon da yo.
A little too thick. Don't exaggerate now.
Maa, arigatai koto ne.
Don't worry about it.
Tokoro de, Kyousuke-kun wa shumi toka aru no?
Sore ima otou-san ga kiita yo.
Kaa-san, mixi datte.
As my words left me, the phone rang. Ah, excuse me for a moment. It's a call from a client.
Nanda? Mixi ka?
Otou-san, shizuka ni shite yo.
Oh, so da na. Denwa da na. Minna, shizumare.
Oh!
Oh! What a unified family. I'll call back later.
Are? Ii no?
No, it looks like they hung up.
Chotto, minna ga sawagashiku shiteru kara da yo.
Ara, gomen ne.
Kyousuke-kun wa isogashii hito nan da kara, kondo kara denwa kakatte kita toki wa shizuka ni shite ne.
Hai.
Hai.
The dad said that too. Apparently neither her siblings nor her parents will go against her. Oh well, you don't have to worry about me. Let's just try to enjoy our time together. That doesn't sound like me at all.
Kyousuke-kun? Niko niko shiteru yo.
Hmm?
Konna nan ni mo nai uchi de tanoshinde muraete nani yori da yo.
Right.
Kyousuke-kun ga tanoshisou da to watashi mo ureshii na.
As she said those words, she brought the rice-laden chopsticks to my mouth. If I could talk.
Hai, tabete.
She's so sweet, she's giving me a toothache. Despite everything, even if they don't have a scent to their name, this family shines.
Kyousuke-kun, ippai yaru kai?
Sorry, I'm completely stuffed. Tsubaki busily changed her brothers and sisters' clothes, washed them, and coaxed them to sleep. Only her father and I were left in the living room.
Kimi ni wa ie no koto dake janakute Tsubaki no mendou made mite morau koto ni natta ne.
The two of us going out has already become something of a pretense for our marriage. How is everything? Have your preparations for the big move been going smoothly?
Okata owatteru yo. Kono ima igai wa sappuke na mon da yo.
You've left the living room for last?
Sou da ne. Koko wa kazoku no danran no ba da kara ne. Saigo no toride という mon sa.
His eyes wandered around the room, full of emotion. My gaze followed his. There are tear marks all over the tatami, and the walls all have holes. Tsubaki's dad poured himself another drink.
Hora, ano kiwaku ga aru daro, denjou no.
Yeah, you mean the one that's a little darker than the rest?
Kogetan da yo.
He suddenly started laughing.
Nabe o shita toki ni ne, Tsubaki ga boya o okoshite ne. Iya, ano toki wa taihen datta.
So even Tsubaki can be careless.
Tsubaki wa motomoto ukkari shiteru yo. Demo, kore dake no oujo dai to, jibun wa shikkari shinakya tte omotteru janai kana.
You think? After that, Tsubaki's father went silent. Maybe he's normally a person who doesn't talk much.
Kyousuke-kun.
Yes? Suddenly, he met my gaze.
Chotto ii kana?
Huh? I have a bad feeling about this. What if he plans to say that he doesn't want to give up this house? Will he try to use me, his daughter's boyfriend, to get the house back?
君はあまり家族とご飯を食べてないんだろう。
Did Tsubaki say that? He slowly shook his head.
さっきご飯を一緒に食べて気づいたんだ。君は僕が箸に手をつけるまでは決して食べ始めようとしなかった。
Did I do that? It must have been out of habit.
会食のマナーというやつ。
Are those so-called table manners? We don't use them down here. Perhaps.
そういうのはうちでは必要ないよ。
Huh?
君は椿と同じくらいの年齢の男にしては随分と顔つきが違うね。
What's different about me?
全然違うよ。よく言われないかい。
Who knows?Hearing my muddled answer, Tsubaki's father unexpectedly sighed.
まあ、昔いろいろとあったんだろうし、今もいろいろあるんだろうね。困ったり、寂しかったりしたら、うちに来なさい。
Complicated feelings flooded my heart. What benefit can I receive from a penniless bunch like you? Yet,Why would such an ordinary happy family reach out to someone like me? I don't understand. But I don't have to understand it to realize how comfortable this feeling is. Yes. Finally, a subject in my element. How's it going? I imagine it must be difficult.
I'm running a little bit of a conversation, but I'll talk to you soon about it in the future.
I understand. To tell you the truth, I'm much better at handling subjects like this.
家族団らんみたいなのは苦手っていうのかい?
Maybe it is. I couldn't help but smile wryly. If only I met people like the Miwas when Mother and I were wandering. If there had just been one warm, single warm, passionate person like this.Wiping away the pointless delusion, I chatted with Tsubaki's father for a while. When I announced my departure, Tsubaki walked me to the door. Yeah. Again, I looked down and scratched my head. Does it always feel like this? I mean, the kidnapping just happened, so it must have disturbed the rhythm of the house.Is it normally like this?
そうだよ。うるさいかな?
No. What am I trying to say?
気に入ってくれたら毎日来てくれていいんだよ。
See you tomorrow then.
え、明日?
I thought that was an invitation. Tsubaki puffed out her cheeks.
嬉しいな。明日も会えるんだね。
There's no school tomorrow, so I'll make it happen somehow during a break from work.
お仕事、手伝おうか?
Nah, I'll be fine. Anyway, don't you have things to do here?
私も合間縫って何とかするから。
Great then. I appreciate it. I started considering which tasks to give her. Then come by tomorrow afternoon. You can do the same things as before.
京介君の役に立つことが…私の幸せだよ。
I can't believe she can actually spout lines like, that belong in a TV drama without even batting an eyelash.
あ、そうだそうだ、京介くん。
Tsubaki suddenly waved me back. What?
うちの秘密の入り方、教えておこうと思って。
Huh?
どう?これで鍵がなくても入れるでしょ?
She showed me how to get in by putting specific pressure on the rickety back door. Wait a minute, Tsubaki. You shouldn't be telling outsiders about this.
さすがにね。でも、京介くんは特別だよ。お父さんに言わせれば、もう家族みたいなものだからね。私もそう思うし。
It's too early to talk about that.
いつでも来てほしいんだよ。
Aren't they about to move away, move anyway? Alright, thanks. How about I sneak in during the night and scare you?
Ah, Jesus,
there should be a limit to her defenselessness. See you tomorrow.
Ah, gomenne, hikitomete. Nanka, itsumademo shabette itakute. Demo ne, Kyousuke-kun ga warau to tottemo ureshii yo.
Is it really that rare?
Oh.
Come to think of it, when was the last time I laughed from my heart? See ya. She's really not eager to see me go. Hesitating for just a moment, Tsubaki pressed her body against mine. She grabbed the sleeve of my coat. What is it? Tsubaki closed her eyes, waiting for something. My lips felt moistness upon them, as if something had melted from within my heart.
Arigato.
Tsubaki immediately pulled away.
Jaa ne. Kyousuke-te.
She almost tripped as she all but jumped back into her house. I don't quite know what to do with the warmth these people bring to my heart. Even though the night was freezing, it didn't snow on my way home. Tsubaki's chapter. Alright, we'll go for another few minutes here. I'll leave it to you then. Just like last time, I asked her to organize some documents. After we're done here, let's go out to eat. Tsubaki obediently nodded. Since Tsubaki seems so eager to come today, I think I'll ask her to help more often. Then again, I think she'd probably agree to just about anything I asked of her.
Kyousuke-kun, coffee 入れようか?
Yeah, that'd be great. She's quite clever and never complains. Pretty much the perfect assistant.
でも Kyousuke-kun, お洗濯とかはちゃんとしてるんだね?
Nah, not really.
ちょっと残念。私がしてあげたかったの。
I don't know what on earth was making her so happy, but Tsubaki's face was filled with a smile the whole time. After around 2 hours, the job was pretty much finished. Well then, why don't we head out?
ご飯作ってもいいよ?
Nah, I need to pick up some things while we're out anyway.
何買うのかな? ついてていい?
I was already planning to have you come with me. After cleaning up for a bit, we left the apartment. So, what are you feeling like as far as food goes? What about that restaurant we went to last time? Their lunch menu isn't half bad. They even have salmon, I think. Oh, yeah, I guess I can understand. Let's hit a low-key chain restaurant or something, then.
いいね。家族連れも多いから楽しいしね。
Somewhere with noisy kids, you mean?
うんうん。すっごく可愛いんだよね。見てるだけで時間なくなっちゃう。
Indeed. Despite the noise, it would make for a peaceful, restful experience. Huh. You know, I think what we're doing is normally called a date. Oh. I just realized on my overlay that I think I have two halves of Usami. At least that's what it looks like on my preview here. Oh well. Double Usami for this episode, I guess. After our late lunch, something was bugging me. I mean on the borders, by the way. Tsubaki had been looking delightedly at a baby in the seat behind me the whole time. The thing that's bothering me is the change in my frame of mind.
じゃあ、600円かな?
Huh? Oh yeah. I silently took her money. It's on me. It was on the tip of my tongue, but I swallowed it again.
どうしたの?
It'd be an entirely different situation if she just expected me to pay as the man in the relationship, but she's more than happy to go Dutch. Kinda makes me wonder what would happen if I decided to pick up her check. Then I'd be out 600 yen, big whoop. I was surprised with myself for thinking along these lines. let's go to the department store and take a look at some shoes. The phone rang right after I took her hand. Why now of all times? With hesitation, I pressed the talk button. Hello? Yeah. I immediately covered my mouth with my hand to muffle my conversation. As I talked, I used my gaze and my hand to direct Tsubaki. To stop her from hearing the call, I intentionally pulled away from her. Tsubaki must have also understood my intentions, as she didn't attempt to close the distance as we walked. Yeah. Right, I'll try to take care of it. The call continued. Tsubaki followed me silently, her face not seeming the slightest bit dissatisfied. Yes. Yes, I apologize. It looks like this is going to drag on for a long time. I held out my hand like a repentant Buddhist, telling Tsubaki I was sorry. She spoke softly, with that radiant smile still on her face. With her considerate and well-meant blessing, I kept on talking. The call was finally over. Yeah. It was pretty serious, actually. I'm sorry. I don't think calls that long will come around too often, though. After I pulled myself together, we walked over to the department store. We found most of what we were after. I learned this from an incredible person. It's for the best that one buys his daily necessities in a single trip. This way, one won't waste extra time. I'm the same way. Hey, are you going to be able to carry all that? You're just one girl, you know? Then let me help you. That wasn't why I asked, but... You're saying this because you want to know how much they cost. Kinda. I may not say things like fashion starts at the feet, but I tend to spend a lot of money on shoes. They get scuffed easily. Tsubaki is right by my side. She responds with a smile to every last word that comes out of my mouth. When is your birthday? Never mind. I wanted to give her a present on her birthday, at least, but I was too embarrassed to bring it up. I'm going home now. There's still some work left. I plan to. I'll walk you to the train station. After hearing that, Tsubaki revealed an innocent, childlike smile and took my hand. I went home, responded to some email, and called back some people who left messages on my answering machine. One sec. Sorry about that. It's cold. Still hanging on a little bit. My mind wasn't on it, though. I had too much fun today. And I'm even going to Tsubaki's house soon. Is it okay to spend time on things like this? I might be going out with her right now, but what can I stand to gain from such a relationship? From an economic perspective, spending money on having fun is a cost with no benefit. Even so, I'll be joining that family for dinner again tonight. I'm in a great mood. I guess I could just think of it as a way to dispel stress. Thank you for having me over again. As I feared, I was given a grand welcome.
Kyousuke-kun is officially a member of the family.
She seems to really believe that. Where's your dad?
Papa, Osaka!
Osaka?
Yes, today's
Ah, looking to raise funds, probably. The children sprang up from other rooms. Surrounding a boisterous table, talking about matters of no importance, they managed to provide the atmosphere with an air of passion. Huh? Why me?
Dame?
This kid doesn't even know the meaning of the word stranger.
Ora, Hiroaki. Oni-chan wa isogashii hito na no.
Says the girl carrying a load of laundry. No, it's alright.
Eh, honto? Kaze hiko nai? Soto samui yo?
It should be fine.
Yatta! Jaa iko!
Hiroaki dragged me into the changing room with a sprint. It was a narrow, dirty bathroom. A good number of tiles on the floor were starting to peel off. The gas heater clearly had trouble keeping the water highs. If I'm smaller than you, I'll kill myself. His big, endearing eyes warmed my heart. Exactly like Tsubaki's. Oh, sure. With a soapy sponge, I helped him wash his entire body. Looking at my stomach, Hiroaki tilted his head. Oh, you noticed. I was taken back to something that happened a long time ago. Back in the days when I wandered with Mom. That scar was from a box cutter, after a bunch of heartless demons scorned me on the street, or cornered me on the streets. Can you keep this a secret from your sister?
Nande?
Just do it. Promise me.
Wakatta!
It was natural for an underprivileged kid like me to be bullied. At the time, I didn't feel any anger or any sadness. It's not even a big scar. If Tsubaki found out about it, she'd start worrying over nothing. Suddenly, something tickled my back. Hey! Thanks. Alright, Hiroaki, let's count to 10 and then get dry and dressed. The so-called change of clothes happened to be underwear and pajamas that belonged to Tsubaki's father. We'll see, kid. It's been a long time since I've taken a bath with someone. Wait, was this the first time I've had one with someone other than my parents? Sure. Tsubaki always seems to be thinking of me. After my quiet answer, she scurried off to the kitchen, leaving only her footsteps to break the tranquility of the evening. I've been taking things really leisurely recently, and I don't know why, but my head hasn't hurt at all in the past 2 days. I stretched out on the floor. Even though this isn't my home, I have a peace of mind here that allows me to forget all my worries. Huh? Oh, I must have dozed off for a moment.
Kyousuke-kun, okita?
Did I fall asleep?
Kyou tomatte iku?
Tomorrow's a day off, after all. Tsubaki left my side at 8. Let me try again. Tsubaki left my side at my groggy reply.
Matete, futon yoi suru ne.
Oh, thanks. I'm horribly tired. When I close my eyes, it feels like my entire body is floating in the air. Tsubaki's face was before mine. I love when she just goes, and they translate it as, "You what, baby?" This home. Meaningless, nonsensical sleep talk. Wait, the demolition's already been scheduled. I hear they're putting up a hotel. I wasn't able to answer Tsubaki's question. You don't really want to move, do you? Of course you wouldn't.
でも、いつだったか、京介君が言ったように、 新しい場所でもいくらでも思い出は作れるから。
That's a good attitude.
それでもすごく寂しいけどね。ここは物心ついた時からずっと住んでたから。
I'm sorry.
何が？
Nothing. Never mind. Is this environment intoxicating me?
変な京介くん。日記に書いておこうっと。
I'm gonna steal that diary of yours.
ダメだよ!
Let me see it.
そんなに見たいの?
Yeah. Tsubaki let out a tiny panic noise, like that of a mosquito? What kind of noise does a mosquito make?
いいよ.
Alright, let's see it then.
ダメだよ!
Then when?
私に何かあった時?
Huh?
私に何かあったときは、この日記をどこか目のつく場所に置いておくから。
Come on, don't talk like that. It sounds like a last will and testament. It was a meaningless conversation, but it brought a shred of warmth to my heart. My eyelids grew heavier.
京介君?
I'm not even sure if I responded to her or not. In a home where the residents were about to be chased out, I quickly fell asleep.
ずっと一緒にいてね。
All right. And that is where we are going to call it for this episode, where we are reminded that it's been a week since Kyousuke started going out with Tsubaki. So, as always, thank you guys very much for watching. Hope you're enjoying it as much as I am. And I will see you all next time.